Which means he is fatigued. Did y'all not know that David had had to fight many battles, not just Goliath, but he had other things he had to fight. And now that David is old in age, David needs somebody who can do what he used to do. Oh, y'all not talking to me. Listen, you got to find somebody you can pass the baton to. But it gotta be somebody that got your spirit. It gotta be somebody that got your heart. Oh, y'all not talking, so let me give you the word. Abraham said to the two that were sitting there with the ashes, he said, me and my son are going up to worship, but y'all two stay with the ashes. Y'all not talking. He said, listen, y'all not going where we're going, because only those that have my spirit, only those that are connected to me can go where I'm going. He said, for the rest of y'all that's not trying to go, he said, you can stay with the asses. Y'all not talking up in here. Listen, Elijah told Elijah, he said, listen here, if you want my mantle, if you want a great anointing, he said, when you see me go up, he said, if you can handle what I do, if you can handle what I go through, he said, by the time God raised me up, he said, God is going to raise you up. Only those that have the spirit of their leader can say, I am a son and daughter of a ministry. Why? Because he is an armor bearer. Listen, an armor bearer is one that bears arms. I need some help. Can you hear me, preacher? Listen, this is David, and I am playing the place of Saul. Listen, because David is an armor bearer to me. Nobody should be able to see my flaws. Nobody should be able to see the things that I go through. Nobody should be down there talking. Listen, my nakedness should not be exposed. Y'all not talking. An armor bearer knows how to cover the leader. I'm not an armor bearer because I walk around with my head up and I got a suit on and a badge to say I'm an armor bearer. What makes me an armor bearer is that I got a spirit to serve my head. Y'all not talking. I know how to be humble. Even though I'm a person in authority, I still know how to submit
Amen.
To authority. So listen, Abishai was a coverer. Abishai knew how to cover David. See, you got to realize that every pastor, every leader must be covered. See, I can tell many of y'all don't understand the importance of who you're leading is because you should have been hollering right there. Because you have to always cover. The Bible said that Noah got intoxicated off the world. And therefore, he had a grandson that was mocking him, that was picking at him, was seeing all his flaws and all. But the Bible says his two sons came, picked up a blanket, walked backwards because they knew how to cover. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, I got your back and your front.
Amen.
I got to cover you. I got to cover you because Abishai. Somebody shout Abishai.
Abishai.
To cover. So now it takes us to 2 Samuel chapter 21, around the 15th verse now, because the Bible lets us know before we get there that David spoke to Abishai and said, Abishai, I want Saul to know that God has anointed me. Listen, you don't need to touch him at all. He said, I want you to go in. We're going to go in. We're going to take the spear and we're going to take his cup of water and we're going to get out of there. Y'all got to watch this now. He said, we're going to go in. We're going to take his spear and we're going to take his cup of water and we're going to get out of here. The Bible says that Saul was asleep in the trenches and all of his boys and armor bearers were surrounding him. His head security guard was surrounding him, but somehow, some way, somebody was able to get in the inner circle and get out with stuff that they shouldn't have got out with. Oh, y'all can catch that. See, there's no way if pastor have people around him, then listen, his nakedness should be exposed. There's no way that people that's around pastor should be able to hear about the church business. There's no way that surround the pastor, that listen, the business meeting, all the stuff that was discussed, get out. Oh, y'all not talking.